Do you have spaces inside your numbers and the trim function just isn't removing them? Let me help. Right, let's start with looking at when the trim function does not remove spaces from a number. Now, the reason is when there's a space inside of a number, Excel changes the type of content inside the cell to be text. Even though it looks like a number, it's actually treated as text. And as you know, the trim function, what it does is it removes spaces that are not necessary within a cell within text. So it'll remove spaces before text, any additional spaces between text, meaning if there's two words, and at the end of text as well within the cell. Of course, if the 1, 2, 3 space 5, 4, 6 are seen to be two different words because they're treated as text, you're still going to have one space in between, which is not helpful, right? So let's have a look at how we can use the substitute function to sort this out. So I'm just going to come over to here. I'm on the cell that's actually got the formula in it over here. It's just showing the formula. So I'm just going to press my delete key and we're going to use the substitute function. Substitute. And you can see it there. Pressing my tab key to drop the substitute function in, open bracket. There we go. Now, all I need to do here is go onto the cell that's holding that unnecessary space. Now, I'm just going to go comma. Now, this next bit, you've got options. So if it's a normal space, and if you're unsure of what I'm talking about, just stick around. If it's a normal space, all you have to do is just go quote mark, space, quote mark, and then comma, and then double quotes. And what you're saying is to Excel, what you're saying to Excel is find any normal space and replace it with nothing. And so all I have to do here is just close my bracket, press my enter key, and if it's a normal space, it will remove it. You can see it's not a normal space, right? There's two different types of spaces that travel into Excel. There's normal spaces, which is just like pressing your normal space bar on the keyboard. And then there's hard spaces, and they normally travel when you've copied from a PDF or you've imported from maybe a CRM system or something like that. So this is a hard space. So how do we get rid of a hard space? We need to nest an additional function inside of here. So I'm just going to come into here. I'm going to take out where I was supposing it was a normal space. I'm going to type in here, character. Now, open bracket 160. Now that's the character code 160 for a hard space. So I'm now going to press my enter key and look at that. It's removed it. Yay. So a character 32 is a normal space and a 160 is a hard space. So that's worked, which is fantastic. Stick around. Okay. Now I just want to talk about what we've got now that we've cleaned that data. Excel now is looking at that number and still treating it as text. So if I come down here and click onto this cell, type in 200, and then I'm just going to go ahead and do a sum. Now watch this. So straight away, Excel's looking and only lassoing values, not text. So straight away, you can see there's a problem. Now, even if I go, no, include B4 and press my enter key, look at that. And this might be why you're watching this video right now, because you're experiencing this problem. So there's one extra thing that we need to do with our formula to make it a number. So I'm just going to come back over here, clicking onto the cell that holds my substitute formula. I'm going to go up. I'm going to wrap a value function around the outside of this. Now, value will take the returned value from substitute and make it a number. It's great. So if I go in here, value, open bracket, and then popping a close bracket at the end, pressing my enter key, look at that. So good, right? For videos on related topics, please visit my channel. For links to my courses or my weekly tips, check the description box below.